Aloha everyone, Joshua Hayes at BigWaveTrading.com. I made mention in the chat room this morning that for the first time since this downtrend started at the highs of March, it felt like panic selling in the pre-market before the market opening. We were just waterfalling lower, and this time we were doing it on heavier volume than normal in the pre-market. It had that feel of panic, and sure enough, at the open, I saw the CBOE put call ratio hit a number that my brain can't remember seeing since 2009, 2.1. You can go check the CBOE website, it'll be up there. And during the first hour, 2.1 put call ratio. Closed the day still at an elevated 0.94, 1.01 to 0.94, depending on where you go to get the data. IBD had 0.94, 1.01 was at CBOE. But either way, it's splitting hairs. There's still a lot of bearish bets out there with this reversal, but this reversal looks strong. It just was missing volume, obviously. We never can rally with volume, so nothing surprising here. But the important thing is that you can see on all of these charts I'm showing you, the 200-day moving average, the NYSE, 200-day moving average is holding as the line in the sand. NASDAQ and NASDAQ 100, 200-day moving average is holding before price can even get to it. Russell 2000 bouncing right off the 200-day moving average. Dow Jones Industrial Average, the exact same thing. And the S&P 500, the same thing. So that's good for now. There's a ton of overhead resistance. We have now the downtrending 50-day moving averages to worry about, the recent March highs, then the ultimate January highs in these indexes. So until we get back above the 50-day moving average, see price get support at that 50-day moving average and or the 50-day moving average curl higher, it's going to be really tough for me to be too bullish here. But I'm never bullish or bearish. I just take signals. And the one thing that has remained consistent during this downtrend has been consistent signals. I never went over 40% cash in my account, my main end of day trend following account. And that's not because I was holding on for dear life to long positions. That means that 60% of everything I'm long is still trending higher and or is above the 200-day moving average and or has not yet failed my final cut loss level and or has not yet built a series of three lower highs and lower lows. With that being the case, with the New York Stock Exchange advanced decline line holding strong during this pullback, the Russell 2000 showing relative strength, my holdings holding up, new signals triggering, bearish sentiment rising, especially in the put call ratio, the seen and greed and fear index, it's been really hard to really jump into the bear side, especially considering that I've been telling you all year long, until you see the yield curve invert, my natural inclination is to buy pullbacks, 5%, 10%, 20%. Pullbacks in the market, no matter how big, if a signal triggers, I need to take it and just cut my losses very short whenever I'm wrong. Because until the yield curve inverts, history for 220 plus years suggests to me that you want to buy the dips with leading stocks, especially when leading stocks, i.e. small cap stocks, Russell 2000 names, are holding up. So it should be no surprise that once again, there's a big round of long positions, but the status quo remains that I implemented 2 days ago when it looked like we were about ready to break completely down. 1% per new long position and only 0.5% per extra signal. Per extra scan that stock is in. So it doesn't matter if it's canned slim quality, perfect speculator quality, it's still just 1.5%. It was 2%. It's going to be about 2.5%, 5% in the greatest markets. It's 5%, 5% for 10%. But for right now, the most any stock can get is if it makes every scan and does what DBO did. DBO is actually a 3% new long position because it made five scans. The rest of the stocks, MTCH, that made three scans. That's going to be 2%. Then you have UVE, ULH, CNOB, SFLY. Those are all 1.5%. Because they're in multiple scans, and then BXG is only one in one scan. That's an IPO stock, and then TIG was only in one scan as a perfect speculator. That's an ad signal, super thin. I don't want anyone to touch that one. Just watch and learn on that one. This is an R play based on a buyout by Takeda, a company in Japan. Don't know much about it. Just did a quick news glance, and I just think that this stock's going to move higher. Basically, a bidding war could ensue for this stock. It's in my perfect speculator scan. That's all I really care about. So getting back to the new long positions really quick. DBO. That's 3% of my account capital. Now remember, on all of these trades, I'm looking at the past previous uptrend to try to gauge on the kind of move that I expect with my new long signals. So with all of these previous uptrends in mind, they're all very, very, very large. If you use those previous uptrends as my guideline to the potential reward and use my recommended cut loss levels, especially the first one, the reward to risk ratio is greater than 4-1 on every single name. So DBO, 1104, first cut loss right here, 1080. Second cut loss for me right there, 1040. Final cut loss the last green bop day, 1016 for DBO, 3% of my account capital. Very, very low risk. Let's say all hell breaks loose, the stock breaks down past all my stops, you know, 10% is what I'm going to probably risk if all hell really breaks loose. And I can handle that on this trade because there's no way that's going to happen. It's an ETF. It's not going to happen, period. I don't have to worry about it. Then MTCH, this is 2% of my account capital. Want to get long, limit order, 4279. First cut loss right there, 4046. Second and final cut loss right there, 3847. MTCH, perfect speculator, can slim, confirmed in my price volume bop surge scan. UVE, Universal Insurance Holdings, can slim quality, perfect speculator quality, getting long, limit order, 3245, the high of the day. First cut loss, 3065. Second and final deep cut loss, 2865. But as I always say, and it never changes, the first stop level goes on a normal nice pullback, then I move half of whatever remains to the next new level. If the first stop goes on heavier volume or loses the green bop catalyst, all my stop gets raised, and this final stop will never come into play. So just remember that. My final cut loss is 38.47 for now. That's my initial stop. We'll see if it remains once UVE starts trading the next day. CNOB, want to get long CNOB, limit order high day 29.05. First cut loss level right there, 27.85. Second cut loss level right there, 27.20. Then ULH, one that we tried earlier here, rolled over due to the market. Let's try this bounce now that we've got a big bop surge, big volume surge, pocket pivot point signal. Want to get long, 1.5% of my account capital, 21.20. First cut loss right there, 20.35. Final cut loss, the 200-day moving average is at 20. It's basically splitting hairs. I will probably only use one stop level at 20 for this trade. SFLY, perfect speculator quality, semi-cancelum quality, just like ULH. Right at this 50-day moving average, the BOP surge isn't that great, but it is very green. And even though there's no volume surge, I tell you what, my first level of risk is just so low compared to the previous uptrend. I would feel really stupid if I don't take this trade based on the setup and if it ends up working. If it fails, I don't care. Tiny losses. Limit order 79.78, 1.5% of my capital. First cut loss 76.44. Final emergency cut loss for now 67.99. You can be damn sure though, if that first stop level goes, this one will never come into play unless it crashes on Thursday. Don't think that's going to happen. BXG, this was in my IPO scan. Even though BOP has been going the wrong way the last two sessions, I wanted to buy it yesterday. I didn't, since it was day one, BOP going the wrong way. And even though BOP's going the wrong way again, it's still at a very elevated green level. If we're up tomorrow or base sideways, it could easily grow again. With this much green on this IPO chart, I want to take it. So 0.75% of my account capital, because it's ever so slightly extended from the 20-day moving average by just a few cents. Don't want to reduce it completely in half, so I'll just reduce it by 25%. 0.75% of my account capital, BXG, 21.64, the limit order, the close. First cut loss, 20.72. Final cut loss, emergency cut loss. Final cut loss 2072. You could also use 2052, which is going to be my first stop that I use. And then I'm actually willing to let the stock trade down to 1935 on my final half. But I recommend everyone just using that last green bop day as your final stop. So I think I went through everything. BXG, Oh, yeah, TIG. Just forget about it. TIG, you can look at the limits and stops if you want to. You can see the pattern right here, but as thin as it is, just ignore it. Forget about it. So DBO, BXG, SFLY, ULH, CNOB, MTCH, UVE. You have plenty to choose from. There is not a lack of long signals out there. So just pick the one that you like. Obey my first recommended stop level. And you can even go back up to, if you got a smaller size account, 5% of your capital per position. I don't recommend 10% of your capital per position just yet. I would wait for a follow-through day. As I say in the new positions page, if you go read it right now, it's only day two of a rally attempt. Nothing more, nothing less, but a lot of positives in today's session.